Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Thank you for joining us for today's ISS update this Thursday, September 22nd. Aboard the orbiting complex, Station Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Sergei Volkov are working through their first full week aboard the orbiting complex as the Expedition 29 crew since the departure last week of their Expedition 28 crew members. Commander Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa docked to the Rosviet module of the space station this summer on June 9 aboard their Soyuz spacecraft. They have completed their 100th consecutive day in space last week with a couple months remaining of their stay in space. Meanwhile, astronaut Dan Burbank and cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin are scheduled to join the crew of three there on the space station after their launch on November 14 to make up the full crew and complete the mission of Expedition 29. On orbit, the expedition crew members are busy supporting ongoing research into the effects of microgravity on the human body, biology, physics, and materials, as well as performing regular maintenance activities to their orbital home away from home. After the crews wake up at 1 a.m. Central Time today, the expedition crew participated in the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. The crew will participate in another daily planning conference just before entering its pre-sleep period. The crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineer Satoshi Furukawa are wrapping up an educational demonstration on advanced robotics. The pair recorded an educational video on Robonaut 2, or R2, the first dexterous humanoid robot in space that could one day assist a future crew with repetitive tasks or tasks too dangerous for humans on orbit. While Furukawa will then stow away the hardware used for the educational video, Fossum will spend much of the hour on critical station responsibilities, preparing and emptying a waste urine container in preparation for tomorrow's repair to the water recovery system. Meanwhile, on the Russian side of the house, Flight Engineer Volkov is tending to the Russian Plants 2 experiment, watering and photographing the experiment plants on board. Volkov also will perform regular maintenance to the Soyuz system. This is the Russian Environment and Life Support System. At the bottom of today's update hour, he and Furukawa will put in their second hour of their daily two-hour planned exercise regime. Earlier this morning, Commander Fossum and Furukawa collected more biology samples as part of a mycology evaluation and stored the samples into the minus 80-degree laboratory freezer for later analysis. Flight Engineer Sergei Volkov conducted several window inspections and photography on the Russian segment of the station and also performed an oxygen repress from the docked Progress resupply ship. Later today, Fossum will participate in an inventory management system and stowage conference with the ground and wrap up his two-hour exercise regime with an hour of strength training using the advanced resistive exercise device that simulates weightlifting here on Earth. Furukawa will participate in onboard training of evaluation and monitoring of microbiofilms inside the International Space Station. He also will join elementary students in Louisiana via ham radio to talk about life in space and other space-related subjects. Flight Engineer Volkov will work on a Russian experiment known as Interaction before the close of another productive workday in space.